Access for Everyone, Breaking Down Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities. Topic 18, Video Captioning.
You're a content creator for your educational community, and you just made an awesome video. Congratulations. Likely, you've also taken the appropriate steps to make sure your video is accessible to individuals with disabilities, including people who are deaf or hard of hearing. Many people in your school community may use auto captioning or captions generated automatically by speech recognition technology. This technology is pretty incredible, but you don't want to over-rely on it either.
We've learned that a number of schools, both at the K-12 and post-secondary levels, don't regularly check the accuracy of captions. Auto captions are not always accurate, even under perfect recording conditions, and can be even less accurate when the content or setting of the video makes it difficult for technology to recognize speech. In fact, auto captioning is at its worst if the speaker is speaking quickly, the speaker's voice is muffled or they're mumbling, the speaker speaks with an accent less familiar to the auto captioning's artificial intelligence system, there are multiple speakers, the video is highly technical, or if there's a lot of background noise. In other words, auto captioning can lead to inaccurate and inaccessible results.
In this video, we'll look at some audio captioning fails, then clarify how having good systems to ensure correct captioning avoids inadvertent accessibility barriers for students who rely on captions. First, let's look at some fails. There are unfortunately too many to choose from, but these three examples highlight how words can be captioned differently from what was actually spoken. Here's our first example. The staff member featured in a video said, "Participating in a summer opportunity, whether it be an unpaid internship with a judge or in a legal aid office." But the auto captioning reads, "Whether it be an unpaid internship with a judge or in an illegal aid office." In that example, auto captioning changed the word entirely and gave the impression that the aid office was not legal.
In this next example, the auto captioning fails to distinguish between different speakers and, similar to the first example, captures the wrong words. In a soccer player's profile film, the first speaker said, "What are a few things that you think are her greatest strengths?" To which the second speaker replied, "Well, I like that she takes advantage of her center of gravity, being a shorter player." Unfortunately, the auto captioning reads, "If you things that you think I like her greatest strength, while I like to be taking advantage of the center of gravity, versus Venus shorter player." It's obvious that auto captioning here turned the speaker's similar sounding words into an incomprehensible word jumble.
Our last example comes from a video about a club that brings together students with and without disabilities for friendship and activities. The student said, "I would always see my friends from the Unified Club in the hallways." But it was captioned as, "I would always see my friends from the Union Fight Club in the hallways." Although it's possible that a Union Fight Club exists and that there are groups of friends within that club, this is clearly not the intended message about an organization that supports relationship building. In addition to providing the necessary accessibility for students with disabilities, accurate captioning may be beneficial for other viewers as well. Consider your viewers for whom English is not their first language. Captioning may help these viewers understand the video as you intended it to be. Or you may have viewers who are watching the video in loud environments where it's difficult to hear the audio track, or in very quiet environments where they cannot turn up the volume, so they may rely on captioning more than usual. Accurate captioning also can help schools avoid complaints and litigation.
At the end of the day, after you spend a lot of time, effort, and energy producing a video with a specific message, you want all of your viewers to understand that message, including those relying on captioning. So, what can you do to prevent poor captioning from occurring in your videos? The solution is actually quite simple. Check the accuracy of the captions and make corrections. Most video hosting sites that have the ability to auto-caption also allow a user to manually edit auto-captions on their posted videos. This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ED.gov.